Okay, so dear students, this is my third video on how to balance equations, okay, in chemistry. So in the last two parts, I explained a new method of balancing chemical equations. The method is more of mathematical, and I have given two examples in the previous two videos. I first took a very simple example, then I took a little more difficult example. In the third video, I have taken an example where ions are also involved. So in this video, I will apply the concept to balance this equation, which people usually find very difficult to balance by other methods of chemistry. Okay? So in this video, we will balance this equation by the method which I covered in the last two videos. So we will start now. So here, you see both sides. Mn is appearing only here and here. So suppose I write A here. So I must write A here, because Mn atoms have to be balanced. Okay. Now, if I write A here, then oxygen atoms will be 4. And oxygen appears here. That means I have to write 4A here. Okay, because oxygen does not appear anywhere else other than this and this. So 4A atoms of oxygen here. We must make sure that 4A oxygen atoms appear on the right hand side also. Okay, now suppose I write B here. So iron appears here and here only. That means I must write B here as well. Now hydrogen appears here and here. This side we have 8A, 4 into 2, 8A hydrogen atoms. So we must make sure that 8A hydrogen appears here. Okay, so now we have written the numbers everywhere. Now we will balance the charge. So this side, how much of charge is there? Minus A, because negative charge, plus 2B because positive charge, plus 8A. That must be equal to total charge this side also. So equal to 2A plus 3B, because one Fe atom has plus 3 charge, plus 0. There is no charge in H2O. So this equation becomes 8A minus A minus 2A. So 5A equal to 3B minus 2B equal to B. Okay? So I taught you that we have to make sure all the coefficients become integer and this equation is also satisfied. To satisfy this equation, the minimum A I can take is 1 and minimum B I can take is 5, because then 5 equal to 5. Now I can substitute A and B values in the original equation. So it becomes MnO4 minus plus 5 Fe plus 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 8 H plus equal to H1 Mn plus 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 5 Fe 3 plus plus 4 H2O. Now we will check this side. 1 Mn 1 Mn, 4 oxygen 4 oxygen, 8 hydrogen 8 hydrogen, and 5 and 5 iron atoms. Charge. Okay, I'm sorry, I think I wrote this little bit off, so I write it here. Plus, A was 1, so 4 is 2. Okay. So now, charge we have to count. Minus 1, plus 10, plus 8. So 10 plus 8 is 18, 18 minus 1 is 17 this side, and this side 5, 3 is 15, plus 2 is 17. So you can see our equation is balanced. This method is really easy, and you can write in comments if you have any doubts or if you have new equation which you are not able to balance by this method. I can help you. Please subscribe, share and like the video. Thank you so much.